Canada is back on top of the hockey world after capturing gold at the World Junior Hockey Championship in Buffalo, New York. And one guy that played a big role was Warriors captain Brett Howden. And Brett, I want to go back first to the selection camp. But I talked to you before you left, and you know, people asked me what you were looking like going in. And I said Brett was focused and determined. When you got to the selection camp, do you think that followed through as you made your way and eventually made the team?
Yeah, you know, it's a pretty nerve-wracking time, especially with me knowing what happened last year. I really didn't want that to happen again. And, you know, it's a quick camp. It's like only a couple days and they make the decision. So you got to show your best in that short of time. And everybody that came was really, really focused and determined. So, you know, everything worked out for the best.
How do you feel as though you were able to set yourself apart?
I think I just tried to do what I could do best and not try to stay safe. I think that's the biggest thing that I talked with Tim and Al, is to get out of my comfort zone and you know, try things that I'm not you know, used to. Trying to play harder and you know, trying to, you know, be a difference maker out there, not just settling in for you know, being safe. So I think I did that pretty well. And you know, like I said, it kind of worked out in the end.
Do you feel as though when you play for Hockey Canada, it's your willingness to accept a different role than what you're typically with your club team that can maybe help you make that team?
Yeah, I think that's the biggest reason why, you know, lots of the guys make the team, is because the guys that make it are willing to accept any role and adapt to it and do it the best they can. You know, that's how Canada is always a winning team, is that they always have guys willing to play different roles and, you know, do it to the best of their ability. And I think that's what we had. We had a group of guys that wanted to win, doing anything that they could to help the team. And that was my mindset going in as well.
Watching the team from a distance, Brett, it seemed like you guys were a tight-knit group. Would you agree with that?
Yeah, I think that's one of the biggest reasons why we did so well, is because off the ice we had great chemistry. We're a really tight group. And you know, we all really knew each other before we went there, whether we played with or against each other at some point. So I think that really helped us out, and you know, it was a really fun group to be a part of.
What was the outdoor game like against the Americans? A once-in-a-lifetime experience. And again, you know, we were watching that on the way to Brandon on the bus. It seemed like it was a snowy day. What was it like for you?
Yeah, it was a crazy day. It was probably the coolest thing I've ever done. You know, just from the atmosphere in the crowd with 45,000 people there, and there's a band playing, and then in the second it started snowing, and you know, there was a good inch or two on the ice, and you know, you couldn't even see the puck on the ice at some points. It was just flipping it high and skating onto it. So it was definitely an amazing experience that I'll never forget. And you know, we were really lucky to be a part of that.
It was a shootout loss. Do you feel as though that loss maybe helped to pull this team even closer together as you guys got ready to finish off the preliminary round and then head into the playoffs?
Yeah, I honestly think that that game was a big turnaround for us. You know, it kept us honest. We didn't, you know, I think we kind of let off a little bit in that game, and you know, them coming back and winning that, obviously we didn't want to have that happen, but it's probably good it happened at that time instead of later on in the tournament. So I think that game really helped us, you know, really shape up our game.
Have you ever played in a more intense game than that gold medal against Sweden?
No, that was the biggest game I've ever played. You know, after the game we were talking about how much better it felt, that it was a really good game. You know, it wasn't a blowout. It was a great game. It could have gone either way. Teams played right till the end, and for us to get that goal in the last minute and a half was pretty special. It's pretty hard to put into words.
Is it hard to describe what it's like to stand on the blue line and hear your nation's anthem, and you have a gold medal around your neck?
Yeah, it was, you know, it's crazy. You just get chills thinking about it. I remember being in that exact building when Quinton lost in the gold medal game. They were up 3-0 going in the third against the Russians and lost 5-3. And I just remember being crushed as a little kid. I think I was more sad than he was. I was crying, and you know, it wasn't fun. And I could see how sad he was and the rest of the team. And for us to win it there with that kind of, you know, memories in the back of my head was, you know, it was pretty amazing.